Hello student, welcome to my channel. This is Vasant Naik from Kendra Engineering College. Today we will see one more concept that is called as a entered variable map. The concept is known as a entered variable map. So we know any Boolean expression can be solved by 4 to 5 different methods. One is Boolean laws and theorems. Second one is K-map. We have seen in K-map, we have two types, SOP and POS, sum of product and product of sum. By using this, you can solve Boolean expression. Third one is called as entered variable map or MEV, map entered variable. Let me repeat, entered variable map or map entered variable. Fourth one is called as Q-map. Now, in this class, we will see what is entered variable map. Entered variable map is the one in which one of the variable, input variable is represented inside the map as an input. One of the variable is represented inside the map as an input. That is called as entered variable map. You will come to know that. So, what is the advantage of this one? Advantage is this will reduce 4 variable map into 3 variable map. Or 3 variable map into 2 variable. So, let me repeat, what is entered variable map? Entered variable map is a type of K-map in which one of the variable is represented inside the map as input and you will try to solve the map. So, now we will take one example. So, let me take one example here. The example is a function of 4 variable, that is function of 4 variable. I will write here function of 4 variable, that is A, B, C and D. A, B, C, D is equal to, let me correct the pen first. Function of 4 variable is equal to, here, so it is summation M. And min terms are given 3, 4, 5, 7 and 8, 11, 12, 13 and 15. These are the min terms. Function of 4 variable. We have to solve this one by using entered variable map. Solve this one. Using EVM method. This is the exam question. EVM method. So, you know this is a 4 variable. So, here you can see. So, the problem statement is this one. Let me minimize this one. Now, I have taken 4 variable A, B, C, D. First, I will write the truth table as usual 0, 0, 0, 1. I have given different color to this column. I will explain you later. 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, like 16 combinations. Now, after this, I will isolate this column. So, I will isolate this column. When you isolate this column, then you will see here 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. As one group, you will see this as a one group, and that group I will call M0 and D0. 001 and 001, one group, min term 1. 010, 010, min term 2. 011, 011, min term 3. 010, min term 4. 101 minterm 5, 110 minterm 6, and 111 minterm 7. Like, when I isolate variable D and if I consider only ABC, then I will get 3 7 groups like this, 0 to 7, total 8 groups, 0 to 7. Now, let me write according to the truth table output. So, according to the truth table and according to the problem statement, let me write the output. So, output says 3, 4. So, if you suppose if you want to see problem statement, this one 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 11, 12, 13, 15. So, let me write first 3. First one is M0, M1, M2, M3. Here I will write 1, M3, then M4, 1, M5, 1, M6 is 0, and this and all 0, 0, 0, 0, and M7 is 1, M8 is 1. So, please don't confuse with this one is this one. This M here, please treat this as a lowercase m, M0 or D0 with respect to 3 variable. This one I am talking with respect to entire truth table, 4 variable truth table. This is the M8. M8 is equal to 1. M9 is equal to 0. M10 is equal to 0. M11 is equal to 1. M12 is equal to 1. M13 is equal to 1. M14 is equal to 0. M15 is equal to 1. Let me align this one a bit properly. So, bold, and let me give some color for this one. Is this one? So, this is the output according to truth table. Now, we have to write EVM for this one. EVM for this truth table. While writing EVM, you have to see two things. D variable and Y. When input is 0, output is 0. When input is 1, output is 0. That means when input changes from 0 to 1, there is no change in the output. Output remains 0. So, what I can conclude, output is 0 irrespective of input. Similarly, when input is 0, output is 0. When input is 1, output is 1. That means output is following input. When input is 0, output is 0. Input is 1, output is 1. Output is following input. That means I can write here D input. And similarly, when input is 0, output is 1. Input is 1, output is 1. Output is not following input. It is 1 irrespective of input. Then input is 0, output is 0. Input is 1, output is 1. That means I have to do a bit correction here. Let me continue. So, when input is 0, output is 0. Input is 1, output is 1. Means, output is following input. I can write here D. Then, I can write here D. Where here also, input is 0, output is 1. Input is 1, output is 0. That means, input is 0, output is 1. Input is 1, output is 0. Output is the invert of input. So, I can write here D bar. I can write here, let me write this D bar. Let me write here. D bar, before that. Yeah, you can see there D bar is written somehow D bar. And in the next case, that is when the input is 0, output is 0, input is 1, output is 1. That is means output is following input D. Input is 0, output is 1, input is 1, output is 1. Output is not following input, output is 1 irrespective of any changes in the input. When input is 0, output is 0, input is 1, output is 1 means output is following input D. So these are the EVM variables we got. Now we have to represent this EVM variable in KMap. That is, we have to represent this in a three variable KMap. Let's see that one. So students, this is the problem statement. You have to solve by using EVM. So we have already constructed EVM table. You can see here, this is the EVM table. This is the EVM table, right? And we got EVM variables that we have to represent now in a KMap. So now we will take the KMap. Now we will represent the EVM variable. So what is EVM variable M0 here? M0 is a 0. You can see here M0 is a 0. So let me represent M0 is equal to M0. That is M0 is equal to 0. So let me represent M0 is equal to 0 here. M0 is equal to 0. M0 is equal to 0. Then what is M1? M1 is equal to D. M1 is equal to D. M1 is equal to D. Then what is M2? M2 is equal to 1. This is M2. M2 is equal to 1. What is M3? M3 is equal to once again D. What is M4? M4 is equal to D bar. So you have to write like this D bar. What is M5? M5 is equal to D. M6. M6 is equal to 1. M7. M7 is equal to D. M7 is equal to D. Now, I have represented this EVM, what I got in this three variable table. So this is the actual use of entered variable map. Four variable expressions, four variable table we are representing in a three variable map by taking one of the variable ABCD D as an input, and we are trying to solve it. See here, D is the variable that is inside the map itself, inside the map itself. That is the advantage. So now we'll make the group. So we'll make the group. We'll make the group. So first group is this is the first group I will make. I will make a group of D by considering D is equal to 1. That's the one group I can make, and I will call this group as G1. And anyway, this 1 and 1 I will make a group. This I will call this as G2. And here I will club this D bar with the 1, and I will make one more group, and I will call this as a G3. So first I will make a group of D and one more group of 1, and I will club this with this, and I will call this as a group of. Now what is a group of G1? What is the answer for G1? G1 is equal to, vertically it will get cancelled, horizontally it is C is the common. C is the common, but you have to multiply by D because D is inside the table. So C and D is the answer for the first group. For this group, answer is G2, answer is BC bar. And G3 group, answer is G3 group, answer is A, and common is C bar. A common is C bar, and we have to multiply by D bar because you have variable inside the table D bar. Variable inside the table. So now the final expression is final expression for SOP by using EVM is CD plus BC bar plus AC bar and D bar. AC bar and D bar. This is the final expression. So let me summarize this one. This is the problem statement, and we have created EVM table. Then we have solved it by using a three variable K-map. So only thing is here one variable is inside the table. So that variable you have to consider while simplifying the particular group. Thank you.